So in this video, I'm going to be upgrading the stock SSD from 1TB to 4TB on my GPD Win 4. The first thing you need to do is remove all the screws from the GPD. There are 6 on the back and 2 at the bottom. To pry it open, I don't know off screen as it was a little finicky, but if you start from the sides and then to the top and then the bottom, you should be fine. Once open, be careful not to yank it open as there are 2 wires attached to the board. Carefully remove them and set it to one side. Remove the fan, which is held on by 2 screws. Remove the cable connector and the tape at the top. At this point you can actually replace the SSD, but as I've got it open I thought I'd give it a bit of a clean as well as replacing the thermal paste. So there are 2 heatsinks you will need to remove. Also remember to disconnect the battery. Clean off the old thermal paste with some IPA. For the SSD, it's a full size NVMe M.2 drive. Unscrew the single screw and disconnect it from the connector. And pop in your new SSD. I also added the SSD I bought in the description below if you want to get the same one as I did. I've added some additional thermal pads as recommended in some Reddit posts. And also remember to replace the thermal paste. And at this point, it's pretty much doing everything we did in reverse and assembling everything back together. When installing the heatsink, you may have noticed something I didn't do. Yep, don't forget to connect the battery back. Once assembled, there is one final thing you would need to add, and that's the trim piece. You're pretty much going to destroy it when you disassemble your GPD, but luckily GPD has supplied an extra one in the box. It's just held on by some adhesive, just take the tape off and stick it on. Onto the software. Visit the GPD service and support page and navigate to the Windows 11 firmware section. Just click on the download button and download it somewhere on your computer. It's a zip file, so simply unzip it. And once unzipped, we can plug in a spare USB stick that has more than 16 gigs of storage. Format it to NTFS and name the volume label as WinEE in capitals. Once done, go back to your unzip files and copy all the files from the folder and simply paste it all inside the USB stick. Eject the USB and stick it inside your GPD. Boot the GPD and hold down the function and F7 key. This should launch a blue box to select the boot device. Select your USB stick and press enter. This should now just install the OS as it was when you first got your GPD, and you have to set up your device as you would on a normal Windows machine. And now you should be able to see that your GPD is now 4 TB, or just under. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers!